Today we are here at the Cimarron Valley Research Station to take a look at a few interesting fruits. And joining us today is Becky Carroll. Thanks for having us out here, Becky.
Sure.
So it looks like we've got some figs that overwinter. Tell us a little bit about the fig in general.
Well, figs are kind of an interesting plant. These are common figs, and they like hot, dry conditions, but the fruit will size better with a little bit of irrigation. Most of the figs that we grow are only hardy to about 17 degrees. So we usually have bushes instead of trees, where you might see fig trees in other areas that don't get as cold. We're going to have more of a bush, unless it's been overwintered or protected from the cold.
And they overwinter in their rootstock, is that
yes.
correct? So you'll see this die back but regrow? Mm-hmm.
Yes, in the winter, all of this tissue will die back to the ground. They'll send up maybe sometimes double the amount of shoots the next season. And they're very slow to come out in the spring. So you think, oh, my fig's dead. But they're just waiting for it to get warm enough to actually start growing.
All right. Well, it looks like we've got a good crop here. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about how they ripen as they go
up. All right. So you can see on this one shoot, this one stem, they start producing a fruit at each one of these leaf nodes. And so it's pretty neat to see, you know, we have fruit ripening from all the way down to the very top. They're very tiny. And these probably won't make it to ripening because once we get to that hard freeze time, this plant is done.
Okay.
But they'll start ripening in late August, early September. And you can see they're very erect. They stand straight up at these leaf nodes whenever they're ripening. But once they get to that stage when they are ripe, they start to droop or hang down. This one probably has another day or so, but this one on this other shoot right here is hanging down a lot, and this one as well. And so they pull off very easily, right? And you can see it's kind of dripping this white latex substance. Some people are allergic to that, so you need to be careful if you don't know. But it will stop dripping soon. But the leaf tissue and where the fruit comes off, it will have that latex substance.
And they're not necessarily red, is that true about the
ripening? Right, yeah, you can't tell by the color. Some are going to be green when they're ripe.
Okay.
And so some of the different varieties are green, some are brown, some are purple. So you can't go by coloring.
Okay. Well, with that many on there, I know a lot of times when we're talking fruit trees, we have to kind of thin the crop load. Do you have to do that with these?
Or? We don't really thin the fruit on the shoots, but we might go ahead and pinch out the top of these shoots if we want to send more energy into ripening that fruit.
Okay.
Or you might thin out some of the shoots if they have an abundance of new shoots. Thin out some of those, maybe leave, you know, 7 or 8 of the most vigorous and have those put all the energy into ripening those fruits.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about just the maintenance of the plants throughout the season. Best time to plant them, any disease, pest problems?
Right. Now, most of the time I recommend planting fruit trees either in the fall or in the spring, about mid-February, early March.
Okay.
On figs, I like to wait a little bit longer, maybe April, even into May, and avoid those late spring freezes that we get. And so planting is pretty simple. We like to make sure that we have them mulched heavily to keep the weeds and the moisture in. And they don't require a lot of irrigation. They like those hot, dry conditions. But with water, the fruit's gonna size a little bit better. So I think they're pretty adapted. You don't wanna put it in an area that stays too wet, but well-drained soil is gonna be better than something that's gonna hold too much.
Well, I think a lot of times we used to think figs only needed a certain microclimate, but they're very exposed out here. And again, they survived the cool temperatures we had this last winter. Any pest problems or deer problems that there are to mention?
Well, you can see the leaves are really fairly clean. There's not any disease on them that I can see right here, but we had a really wet spring. So you would assume that we were gonna have disease, it would be showing up. So in some areas they report having fig rust, but that's pretty much the only disease that we really have. Now, if they get too dry, the leaves will start to yellow and they'll drop them as well. And on some varieties, if they get too dry, they'll drop the fruit. So irrigation can help that as well.
Okay. But not like a regular fruit tree that definitely needs spraying or anything.
No sprays, not anything like you would expect on other fruit trees. And we had a deer party in here last year about this time, and they ate rubbed every other tree out here and left the figs alone.
Okay.
So.
Well, I know traditionally when we're talking about figs, we tend to recommend the brown turkey fig, which I think has some other names as
well. It does, yeah.
You've got a few different varieties out here. Let's talk about the different varieties.
Sure. This one is a brown turkey. It's also called Texas Everbearing.
Okay.
And then we have LSU Purple, which is the fruit that I've gotten this year. It's shaped a little bit different. It is very dark purple, so it's a little bit smaller.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if this is characteristic or just this season. And then we have Violette de Bordeaux, that is a little bit of a, has a different leaf shape. It's more of a palmated leaf. And the fruit on it is not ripening as well, so I don't know that I'm going to recommend it, but it's one that we're looking at.
And actually makes a good foliage plant,
I think.
It does.
It's very pretty.
All right, so of these, they're planted in the ground out here.
Mm-hmm.
Could somebody grow this in the container if they wanted to?
Yes, and you can keep them alive through the winter. That way, they're not dying back to the ground. You may be able to get a little bit earlier production on them. And so on some figs, they produce a spring fruit that's called a breba crop. I've never seen those in this area, but you can grow them in containers. I have some of those big mineral tubs that I've been growing those in, and then move them into my storm shelter over the winter, and they did great. Just kind of go dormant in there, and then after the threat of a freeze, I'll bring them back out and they'll start growing. Some people also will put them like maybe on the east side of the house and pile hay or straw or something around them to keep them a little bit warmer as well.
So because their roots are exposed, you want to make sure to protect them a little bit better.
That's
okay.
True.
Well, and I know just as a last little thing, this isn't the only kind of fun fruit you're growing out here.
Sure.
You're kind of being adventurous, and you've got some pomegranates also. Do you want to tell us a little bit about what you're finding with the pomegranate?
We have the Russian Salavatsky pomegranate, and it is a hardy pomegranate. They're not going to be the big size that you might find in the grocery store, but we planted them in the spring of 2020, and they actually flowered that year. I went ahead and let them flower thinking they probably wouldn't survive that season, and they flowered, but the fruit dropped off.
Okay.
This year they had put on two flowers after they went through that minus 14
winter. They survived.
They came back out this spring, and then they got bit by that late April freeze, and so there was no green tissue on them late April, but they've come back, and they have a couple of flowers on them this season. One just aborted this weekend, and the other one is developing into a fruit. So we'll see how long it survives. Not something that I really recommend just yet for fruit production, but it's something fun to take a look at.
Yeah, it's a fun little novelty to add to your garden, and it's a beautiful flower,
it
too.
It is, yeah.
All right. Well, obviously, fall isn't just for apples. We
That's
can grow
right.
a lot of other fruits
That's
out here.
That's true.
Thank you so much for
sure.
sharing this with us, Becca.
Uh-huh.
We hope you enjoyed this video as part of our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. You can also find even more videos on the OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion. Thank you.